هايب كمباني الرسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، صهيب الرومي يقص علينا هذا الحديث. أنا أردت أن أنا أقرأ الحديث بنصي حتى لا نقول بمعناه يعني، وطبعا المتخصصين العلماء زي حضراتكم في علم الحديث يعرفون الفرق بين أن تقول الحديث بمعناه أو تقوله بنصي، فرق يعني بينهم، ده له شروط وده له شروط. لما يجي نتكلم في الحديث وسند الحديث وفقه الحديث، علم كبير احنا لسه بنحبه يعني في شواطئ هذه العلم او شواطئ علم الحديث او مصطلح الحديث، فربنا سبحانه وتعالى يعلمنا العلم النافع. الحقيقه الوقت بيجي بسرعه، لكن احنا محتاجين نركز يعني، when you focus about علم الحديث the knowledge of the hadith we have to know the difference between when you say the hadith exactly read it like I read and the meaning of the hadith. You tell the meaning of the hadith. When you tell the hadith, like I read right now, alhamdulillah, we are in a safe side. And also, we tell the story. When did this story to your son before you sleep? What's your name, brother? Muhammad. Muhammad going to sleep and his father, he know this story, and sit down beside him. Tell him, Muhammad, lay down after you make an wudu, Muhammad, and read Ayatul Kursi, inshallah. Lay down on the right hand side as the sunnah, and the father or mother tell him the story. You're gonna raise your kids as the Quran said, as the Hadith Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, right? Let's go focus about some point. يقول the benefit from this hadith. الحقيقة الموضوع والله محتاج حلقتين يعني. We need two حلقة, not only one, because the comment or the benefit from this hadith needs another hour. But inshallah we'll try to make it very shortly because inshallah we finish for 10 minutes inshallah. I take from the website الحقيقة some point here plus I have like 15 or 20 point comment يعني تعليق على الحديث from the scholar. ابن تيمية طبعا everybody knows me, Allah bless him. You have تعليق and another scholar you have تعليق and another our scholar recently right now in different country you have comment about this hadith. So the first one he says جواز الكذب. The first point you take it in it's in our Islam it's not allowed to be liar. No way. Because Rasulullah said he started doing lie and lie and lie until you go to hellfire. And you will say the truth. Keep going until you be صديق and you go to hell, the paradise. The haven, right? يظل الرجل يكذب ويكذب ويكذب حين تكتب عند الله فيدخل النار. مظبوط ولا لا؟ كلكم عارفين الحديث. So in this situation, how come the biggest scholar, راهب, worshipper, you say لا إله إلا الله and you teach the kids, you be a liar. The Sharia said يجوز جواز. It is exception for three times, three situations you can be a liar. It's halal, lawful. It's not forbidden to lie in a sea situation. One of those, this one. خداع العدو والحرب. When you be against the enemy of the Islam or in a war, say one of us, the enemy of the Islam arrest him as a prisoner, a seer. And you ask him, where is the equipment of your Islamic You can tell him, oh, in the top of the mountain, and where is the bullet? Where is the... You tell him everything, he's going to destroy your country. And this situation, the Islam said, lie. Tell him something wrong. Give him wrong place. Are you going to fight with Israel? Example. And the president with president talking together and tell him, are you going to start tomorrow the war? And you, your attention, you will start. You tell him, no, still, we're not ready. He liar. He lie is exception. You can lie and the next day in the morning he attack. موقعة بؤتة. سيدنا زيد he do not mention anything in the war. After صلاة الفجر الله أكبر attack. يا خير الله اركبي. Right away really after فجر time. And he do not mention anything. Even to his people. He don't tell anything to the Muslim people. He said we'll send messenger to Rasulullah ask him Are you attack or you wait until the madad, the help you come, the assistant you come. And next day after Fajr time, Zayd attack. From morning until Maghrib time, you kill all the Romanian people. No one hurt from the Muslim people. Surprise. يفاجئوا المباغتة. See, this is yajuz. It is legally to lie in your enemy. The second one, and most of us, you try to laugh in this situation, but please don't laugh because this is reality. When you lie in your wife, it's legal. I said, don't laugh. Give me your money. She's rich. And I will do this and do that, and I bring the money back, and you don't bring it. No, that's not the lie. No. The ulama said, no, don't do that. You will be a real liar. If you do that, you cheat your wife. But he gave you permission or exception to lie to the awatif, the sentences, romantic situation. Yani example, the ulama said, I don't say anything from myself. The ulama said, if your wife is not beautiful enough, I don't say ugly, but it's not beautiful enough. Even with you, when you go home, you smell onion because she's cooking and she's not dressed up. When somebody comes to visit, like a cousin or family or her sister or her mom, makeup in the house. I'm talking about the Muslim people, not outside that. Inside the house, perfume and smell good. When you go inside the home, you smell, what's the onion, the garlic? Because I'm cooking for you. And you start to make an action, you know, calm down. And this situation to Allah, I love this smell, and absolutely not. I love this food. This food is worse. I love this food. Let me kiss your hand. This is liar, but it is legal lie. You are so beautiful and cute. Like Abdulaziz said, beautiful food and another side. Don't worry about it. It's okay. So this is the second one. You can lie for it. And number three, exception. يعني يعطونا تصريح للكذب للصلح بين المتخاصمين. If two brothers Islamically fight together, it's too hot. You need to put the heater down. So what happened? إذا ذهبت للصلح بين إثنان متخاصمان فالمولى عز وجل يقول إيه؟ إنما المؤمنون إخوة فأصلحوا بين أخويكم. We are Muslim. You have to make صلح. Peace between each other. خلاص؟ وبعدين شوف التعليق الجميل ايه؟ وان يريد اصلاحا يوفق الله بينهم. مين اللي يريد اصلاح؟ مش المتخاصمين اللي رايحين يصالحوا. The people going to make peace, if Allah سبحانه وتعالى he feel you're sincere, he will make it easy for you. Not with the people fighting. And this situation you have exception to lie. I sat down with Dr. Abdul Aziz. Calm down, man. It's not hard too much like that. Okay, three calls for you. Turn off road. So if Brother Abdulaziz fight with Aid, example, and we sit down with the Brother Abdulaziz, he said, he did this, he did that, and start nervous. It's normal. يعني يقعد يتكلم عليه عمل وسوى ويجيب في الأطر الفطر. صح؟ Tell him, brother, I was with him yesterday, the Aid. I was with Brother Abdulaziz, and he says, I love him. I love to go shake hand him, I kiss his hand. Wallahi, I love this guy. And they start talking good about you. I'm liar. Why? Because he says something else. He says, I hate him. He did this, he did that. When he go to the other side, he says, he love you. No?
Las Vegas.
He had my phone. لما تروح تقول له ده بيتكلم عليك كويس وجاب ستك بالخير ده عايز يجي صالحك يا راجل ده امبارح كان بيشعر فيك هدي قلبك. When you go to your wife, the one, مثلا, example, father-in-law or your dad or your sister, trying to make peace between you and your wife, and you tell your wife, you know, my brother yesterday, he was talking very nice about you. He says, you are so cute, your food is nice, and he's scared of my baby, and he don't say that. He says, she's nasty. She never helped me out. She never helped the kids. Look in the Bible. Look, a lot of problems, and she switched it to not, this is